drive down the road, and on both sides it's vacant lots, acres of vacant lots, and roads barricaded with big concrete roadside blocks, like on the expressway, only they're all chipped and cracked and falling apart. As much as a 6-foot-long, 3-foot-high, 1-foot-wide chunk of concrete can dilapidate. And in the middle of the block is a pile of concrete slabs from basements or driveways, all bunched into a rubble cairn of massive proportions, seemingly worn down by age. But they were just stacked that way, rubble in the middle of a lot. And it's that way all down the road, blocks and blocks of desolate land, concrete cairns dotting the land, like they ought to be planning something, but they're not. It's just wasted. This is what's left of Kinloch, the first Negro municipality ever, at least in the United States of America. It was disappeared year by year, razed, flattened, obliterated, and now you drive through it in amazement and wonder at man's inhumanity to man. Some things just strike that chord, send you plummeting into despair so profound that there's actual beauty in it, like a tragic poem or the death of Martin Luther King. The land stretches before, vast and rolling. Trees stand tall in places, accentuating the emptiness. And there are piles of dead trees, too, like 15 feet high and 20 feet long. Branches and trunks of trees all bulldozed up like the concrete slabs. And the acres spread before you like some kind of a plan for a city. Only it's not a plan. It's the opposite of a plan, the reverse of the plan, the undoing of the plan. Only it just looks like a plan if time was going backwards or something. So you could see it like a film running backwards, things tumbling down instead of building up. There were over 10,000 people, black people, living there. And they were run backwards out of existence from this rolling, beautiful emptiness. Now there's only a few hundred souls hanging onto their land, vowing to rebuild, like people do with what they call home. Like people do whose spirit has been shredded into total poverty, but they're still too stubborn to not be proud. And they hang in and hang in. And I'm driving in stunned wonder, numbed by eminent domain gone wild, capitalism grabbing the lifeline of a dying man and collecting the insurance when he dies. The airport owns it all now. You can't even buy any of it and fix it up. You can't farm it. There's just a few houses and churches randomly around. God and people. Poor people, but people.